Hey guys, are you wondering about how lead exposure impacts your health? That's what I will be talking about today in this video. Lead is a heavy metal that was once considered a noble metal. However, in the past few decades, it has come under increasing scrutiny. Concerns range from its adverse impact on human health to the environment to community safety. But when it comes to lead, is it all bad news? Real quick, before getting into the rest of this video, make sure to like this video and subscribe to this channel, so you can get notified when new videos come out about how to remove toxic metals from your body. Also, be sure to take a look at the link in the descriptions below the video, to discover a supplement you can take daily for removing toxic metals from your body. Now back to the rest of the video. So what is lead exactly? Lead is a toxic heavy metal that is known to be harmful to our health. It is a toxic metal found in the air, soil, and water, which can be ingested by plants and animals through ingestion, inhalation, or contact with skin, which is released into the environment by industrial and mining processes. The term lead is also used to refer to two different types of heavy metals found in lead-based paints and gasoline. The first type is lead carbonate. Lead carbonate is used as a pigment in a wide range of household products, including paints, gasoline, and cosmetics. The second type is lead oxide. Lead oxide is usually found in lead-based paints for exterior decoration. Both types of lead are toxic to humans and can cause serious health problems if absorbed through the skin, lungs, or drinking water. This metal has been used in a variety of products, including cigarette filters, water pipes, and batteries. The amount of lead we are exposed to is not only limited to the mining process. This is because lead has been used for a variety of purposes during the manufacturing process. Because lead is so commonly used in our daily lives, it is very difficult to avoid exposure. While there is no total lack of studies on the effects of lead on the human body, the studies that have taken place have shown that lead has very adverse effects on our health. The main adverse effects of lead are on the nervous system and the gastrointestinal tract. But how do you get exposed to lead? Did you know that there are lead-based paints and food containers that can leach harmful levels of lead into your home? Lead is a neurotoxin, so even small amounts of lead can be highly toxic to children and adults. Some of the most dangerous types of lead are known as tin solders because they can leach from the joints of old homes and remain there for decades. The question of how do you get exposed to lead has been raised about the health impact of lead on humans, and the research has been carried out worldwide. Lead exposure is everywhere. It is found in our water, soil, and air. Lead can be found in paint, dust, and other household items. It is used as an additive in food production and cosmetics. There are lead-based pigments in the paints, plastics, and wood used in homes and buildings. Although lead is not a food additive, it is present in several foods that are eaten by children. As the name might suggest, there is a wide range of side effects of lead exposure, including cancer, brain damage, and premature birth. Anytime a person comes in contact with lead in their environment, it is possible to absorb it. Researchers believe that lead exposure is the leading cause of childhood brain damage and lower IQs. As you know, lead is a toxic substance that can be found in many everyday products such as cars, gasoline, solder, and ammunition. Lead has been found to hurt the health of human beings and plays an important role in the generations of lead in the atmosphere. Lead is used as a catalyst in the production of hundreds of different products such as gasoline, paint, pharmaceutical drugs, and pesticides. It is also used in pipes and roofing materials. Lead is also used in the production of batteries and electronic components and is used as an additive in gasoline. But how can you avoid lead exposure? The answer is not a simple yes or no, and rather, it is a complicated answer. Although the risk of lead poisoning is indeed lower than ever before, this doesn't mean that the risk is zero. You can still get lead poisoning from lead-containing products, such as paint, ammunition, and jewelry, even if you don't live in a neighborhood with lead paint. You can also be exposed to lead through natural sources, such as soil, contaminated water, or food. Lead poisoning is a serious health issue and is an ongoing threat to the environment, workers, and the general public. Sadly, removing lead from the body might not be 100% possible. It is because some paints and some types of dust may contain enough lead to cause harmful health effects. It is also possible that older homes may have lead water pipes or that older plumbing fixtures may contain lead. In addition, some people may handle old paint or other lead-containing items without realizing that they are causing lead poisoning. But what are some of the signs and symptoms that you may have lead poisoning? Lead poisoning is a serious health issue that could affect your health for a lifetime. It could cause problems with your child's brain development, especially affecting their ability to learn. The signs and symptoms associated with the harmful effects of lead can include headaches, memory problems, behavior changes, hearing problems, poisoning, and other health effects. Some of these effects can be fatal if left untreated. If you suspect that you or your children are exposed to lead, take action to protect your health. The health effects of lead poisoning have been traditionally attributed to several adverse effects on the nervous system. However, recent research has also begun to shed light on the dangers of lead exposure. In particular, lead can have systemic effects on the body that are not limited to the central nervous system. But is there a way to remove lead from the body? Even though lead has been banned from many products for more than 30 years, lead poisoning is still one of the leading causes of death and disability in the United States. It has been found in the bodies of many adults, too, including those who may have taken up residence in an old house, played in a playground located on a former lead smelting site, or lived in an area where lead-based paint was used. Lead has been present in some form in human blood and bone for thousands of years. For thousands of years, it was considered safe. It took until the 1960s for scientists to realize lead was not healthy. Part of the problem is that lead is a naturally occurring element, and we humans have been ingesting it for ages without even knowing it. Here are my final thoughts on the health impacts of lead exposure. Lead is a neurotoxic metal that has been used in paint, soldering, gasoline, and many other products. It has been found in older homes, frequently found in the dust from deteriorated paint, and naturally occurring in the environment. Children who are most at risk of lead poisoning are most exposed to lead, and the most common source of exposure is lead-painted toys, dust, and soil from old houses. Lead is also used in some vaccines. While the danger of lead poisoning is well known, it is also less well understood. The main takeaway from this post is, you must know where your lead exposure comes from. Try to eliminate the places where you possibly get exposed to lead and take supplements like the one I mentioned in the description of this video. Thanks for watching.